Welcome to the 48th Senior and Interstate Carom Nationals here in Jalgaon. We are about to witness the quarterfinals of this event of the men's singles. And as we see on your screens, this is Zaheer Pasha as the camera goes round. Zaheer Pasha in white representing RBI. He had a tough match yesterday against Yogesh Dhongde. Having lost the first set 10-25, he came back strongly to win at 25-2 and 25-1. And challenging him is Sandeep Dive of Air India in red. Sandeep incidentally defeated top international of yesteryear, Sandeep Devrukar from Petroleum Sports Control Board, or Promotion Board rather, I stand corrected, as both the players shake hands, the customary handshake before and then after the match, of course, to congratulate whosoever wins. The match is being officiated by Ashish Bakker, an international umpire. And let's see if the toss has been made. I'm sitting a bit away from the scene of action. Only the pictures I get live are through the setup that we have over here on YouTube channel of the Maharashtra Carom Association. And to inform you, Carom lovers, the semi-finals and finals also will be played later in the day. And we will definitely show you one of the semi-finals from the men's section. The finals, of course, both the men's and women's will be shown. And if possible, a semi-final from the women's section. So, a feast awaiting you, Carom lovers, today. At least four matches to be shown. So, keep on tuning into MCA, the MCA YouTube channel, to watch some top class Carom. This is the fifth and final day of the tournament. It commenced on the 2nd, and Zaheer Pasha with the break. A supreme artist he is. And Sandeep Dive is a tenacious customer. He knows how to fight. Besides having skills, though not as sublime or as to tell you about Zaheer Pasha, he is currently ranked number 3 in India and Sandeep Dive is 5. So not much of a difference. There may be difference in their play of style of play, in their way of facing the situations, but then both have made it to the top over the years with intense practice. You need commitment, you need hours and hours of practice, and that shows on the board. And hours of practice has to be combined with proper temperament and on the spot decisions. Carom is a game which is played very fast. You have to make your next move or shot in just 10 seconds after having completed the earlier one or after your opponent has completed. So good break here for Zaheer. It's cleared off a lot of Carom men from the board. Just four remaining whites, or five rather, I'm sorry. And Sandeep now playing with the left hand has multiple, impacts on the frame with that striker. When you don't play with your regular hand, you don't exercise that much control. Again, Zaheer, not yet warmed up. Sandeep now playing defensive. Sandeep has been in good form, playing well in some local tournaments. And what a shot that was. This is the result of hours and hours of practice, perfecting a shot. There he breaks it. What does he do? Does he go for the queen towards the right? No, he is trying the one that is far away. There it is. He seems to be in good touch. He has definitely warmed up. 5 and 3, 8 might be the result of the first board if he grabs the queen. Why did he go for the rebound? That's the question I'm asking. And Sandeep, of course, will take the queen, very well knowing that he hasn't much of a chance on this board, so that he minimizes his damage. He's also playing steady. Does he go for a connection? Is it advisable? Oh, just about. Now he has an opportunity to disturb the white. And probably he might win this board. See how things change. Oh no. Sahir, not going to disturb the black, tries the rebound, and this should be Sandeep's board. No, nerves. Very early in the match. He has to blame himself now. Just 1 point. To Zahir. End of the first board. Definitely Sandeep had a chance to surge ahead on Zahir's break. A waiting game, I would say. He's waiting for the umpire to clear that thing, you know. The arrangement of the carom men in the center circle. There should be no gaps. They should be touching each other to the nearest ones. And Sandeep doesn't have a good break. Zahir has a lot available for him, at least 4-5. Depends on how he maneuvers the situation, the positions. Just about. And that is what carom is all about. Power just enough to achieve what you intend to. Go for a rebound. Oh, that was a sharp cut and a rebound to break the cluster. He is well placed now. Sandeep will have to hurry. Having broken unproductively, now he has to produce something. A punch here. Neatly done. These are bread and butter shots for these top players. But sometimes they also commit errors, which magnify into blunders. If the board is lost, or the set is lost, or the match is lost. So a small error may prove decisive. And here Zahir puts Sandeep in a spot of bother. I met Sandeep the other day outside the stadium and was just inquiring as to how he isn't playing that well. So he said, these things happen in your career. There are ups and downs. You do practice, and this is the result of that practice. Zahir has pulled the queen and he's in sight of winning this board. See, he falls short. Even an accomplished player like him misjudges the pace of the board. The impact is far, far weak. breathing space for Sandeep doesn't profit much. And is he going for a rebound? Yes. Just about missed it. This provides Sandeep the opportunity for the second time in the match to pocket the queen and minimize his losses. Bring down the losses. You have to be a businessman also. You have to keep on calculating your losses and your gains. Here he was trying something special. Two in one, as we call it. And Zahir should have a perfect rebound. If he gets it, should be able to... Oh no. Again, the door has slightly opened for Sandeep. Can he grab this opportunity for once? Will he release the striker? No, he couldn't. There was no angle over there. Oh, he grabs it. From losing a big one, he has scored four. So he jumps into the lead. Nothing much. Three is nothing against a player of the caliber of Zahir Pasha. The customary cleaning of the board after every
third board of the first set.
What I would say, every board. So here contemplating rearranging the cluster. So that gets a perfect break. The break is very important. Depends how the carom men scatter. Nothing. Much like Sandeep on the earlier board. Sandeep gets going. There it is. Not much available for him since he has not broken it. So this is the safest way to play defensively, try and get one or two or even three of your men back in a better position. He's got that shot over here, Zahir. Yes. Nicely executed. Again, it's bread and butter. Once you know, the rebound is not working for Zahir. Yesterday too, against Anil, probably. Not Anil, it was Yogesh Dhongde of Jain Irrigations. He failed to produce good rebounds. Sandeep again on the defensive. You need a blend of proper defense and attack at the right time. It's there in every sport. Sandeep, can he go for the queen? Just trying to survey the situation. Yes, second thoughts. Why not the better one to pocket? Maybe he felt that a striker might go and disturb the queen. Here he is now trying to simplify matters. Of course, on the next turn. But how much of a leeway he will have against Zahir, who does well. Then the other one there at the far end will have to be dealt with. was a good attempt. A dual purpose shot. Again, Sandeep, good intentions, but execution not perfect. Now he's got the rebound. That should boost him a bit. Can he manage this one? If he manages this one, oh no, he just fails to touch it. Anyway, he has separated those two. Sandeep also trying to get into a better position. But Zaheer now going for the queen because he has got two whites over there which he can cover immediately. He'll have to think of the last one that's remaining between those two blacks, that pair. Oh, he almost got it. What does Sandeep do? Again, minimize as much as he can and then go for a defensive shot. Oh, he does it. But that won't stop Zaheer from pocketing this one. So he has six now. Or is it three? No, he has six. He has pocketed the queen. So he goes up 7-4 at the end of the third board. It is still neck and neck, I would say. No player has established his supremacy, if I can say that. Very rarely do you see one-sided affairs at this stage of a tournament of the status that it has, the nationals, the country's best tournament, to decide who is the best in India. Carrom has come a long way from its humble beginnings. Now it is getting corporate support, but needs more. More corporates like LIC, who are the principal sponsors over here. Then we have Sky IMF. Saraswat Bank, a multi-scheduled bank, multi-state scheduled bank, let me correct myself. And then there is this petroleum company, Hindustan Petroleum Corporation, who also employ players on their roles. They are supporting Carrom, Indian Oil, Air India, Reserve Bank, then you have Bank of India, so many of them. But Carrom is yet to get bigger recognition. No doubt it is played in about 18 countries around the world. Majority of them are from Asia, like Sri Lanka, Maldives, Malaysia. You have Bangladesh. And here, Sandeep pockets the queen, has to cover, yes. He's on course after not too good a break. He will have to adjust this one. Oh no, slight error of judgment. The slip between the cup and the lip, as they call it. Again, minor things, small, mistimed, I would say, impact. What is he trying to do to disturb the black? There. Pasha. Missing. Sometimes you are up in the clouds and then you are on the ground. Let's see if Sandeep can fly from here. Oh, that dual purpose shot doesn't work. Things are looking rosy for Zaheer. Oh, good alignment of the shot now. So just tip it in. Yeah. Should get a big board despite losing the queen. Four are there for the taking. Four are there for the taking. It gets it, Zahir. He gets going despite losing the queen. 11-4 the lead. At the end of the fourth round, I stand corrected again. Fourth board. So Zahir slowly and steadily trying to get an upper hand. He hasn't exactly. Still four boards to go, and the situation, I can say, isn't so clear in anybody's favor. Slight advantage, 7 points is not a big advantage with four boards to go. I'm waiting for Zahir to have a break to finish. I'm yearning for it. I saw one in the International Carom Federation Cup in Pune about a month ago, where in the Swiss League, this man on to your left of the screen had 7 break to finishes. In all, he had 8. And the others, probably, I'm not so sure, together may not have had that many. Or maybe the top two together may have exceeded the number collected by the others. He is on a roll. Is he going to... The queen has been covered, yes. Oh, I was dreaming about the break to finish, but then the situation was not helping him. Sandeep now. He has to hurry. He has to scurry. If he can minimize his losses, then he will have less worry. He's bubbling with energy, shifting from side to side on the stool. You cannot shift the stool, you can shift your position. Earlier the laws were a little bit strict. You were not permitted to shift the chair, shift your position. And the next board becomes very crucial. He can finish the set within no time. But Sandeep has to come back, win big, to make a match of it. There are 3 quarterfinals simultaneously going on. On one of the boards is world champion Prashant Moray from Reserve Bank and teammate of Zahir Pasha. And then there is Zahid Ahmed facing him from Air India. Nisar Ahmed of Maharashtra is facing Anil Munde. Nisar is a surprise quarterfinalist. He is from the neighboring district of Dhule. So that shows how carom has spread in the state of Maharashtra. And you are getting quality players. And Zaid and Nisar are both left-handers, and left-handers are difficult to deal. But then Anil Munde has dealt with him properly by winning the first set against Nisar Ahmed. Anil Munde is incidentally from Jain Irrigations, who have extended a lot of support for this tournament here in Jalgaon. The matches are played on the Cisco fighter boards. You can see on the board where Sandeep is now playing towards him. The company Cisco is their equipment partner, and carom has become a considerably big industry. Well tried, Zahir. You love to see such shots despite the outcome, whatever it is. Some innovativeness, new things for upcoming players to watch and improve. There it is. I call it the Ghoda Gadi. Some people don't like it, but the Ghoda is followed by the Gadi. How can you put the horse before the cart before the horse? No. And in carom too, the horse goes first and then the cart. Very sharp cut. Very sharp. Razor sharp, I would say. Again, hours and hours of practice reflecting. He must have control. See? Perfect this thing. Measured shot. And now he will be running away with the board. He will. Oh no. That was an accident, I would say. Sometimes the carom men jump off the board. And here comes the defensive shot. But that wouldn't bother Zahir at this stage of the game when shots are flowing right, left and center. 21. So having covered the queen, Zahir inches closer to winning the first set.
हा कलर बघा ना, आता मॅच होतोय तर क्वार्टर आणि सेमीफायनलला मला वाटतं तुम्ही नवीन कॅरम मेन काढावे सेमीफायनल असं मला वाटतं. थोडं सुचवा रेफरीजना.
नाही का वापरलेस? अच्छा अच्छा. पण एखाद्या मॅचला वापरून मग
तो करावा असं मला वाटतं. कुठेतरी एखाद्या मॅचला काढून तो
just discussing with Yogesh Pansalkar, that was in Marathi. Sometimes it becomes difficult to differentiate the queen from the other whites because their color becomes brown and that comes closer to red. Because brown again is a mixture of red and a little bit of black. So the queen over here still open. And with the bright light, those carom men, which the white ones which become brown, they easily match with the queen. That's the problem. That was a perfect hook shot. Only thing is that the coin was not pocketed. Actually, the laws of the game say carom men. But long word, every time you have to repeat carom men, carom men. Coin is a little bit easy to say, easy to understand also. But then I can't go beyond the laws of the game. Even if it is convenient for me to say coin. Sandeep making a basic error. And it will be difficult for him to stop Zahir now, the way he is performing. Slightly wrong shot, but he'll adjust. No. Did his best. Sandeep going for the queen. He has to play desperately now. But desperately doesn't mean that he should throw caution to the winds. Game has to be measured. He has to keep on calculating like a businessman. There he is. disturbing, but that again won't trouble Zahir. I'm sure, yes. Only problem is, how does he deal with this rebound? No, he just turns that black away, forcing Sandeep to go after it. So, a brief update, not the scores, but I am told by my friend here, international umpire Prashant, rather Phansalkar, Yogesh Phansalkar, that besides Anil Munde, Prashant More, the world champion and the ICF runner-up, has won the first set, and so has Irshad, the ICF champions. Faded away, started well, faded away. The margin looks big, but initially, at least the four boards, the first four boards, Sandeep was very much there in the match. But Zahir gained control with immaculate pocketing. Now it is Sandeep to break. Zahir giving this thing a fine scrub. The powder gets stuck to the board due to the moisture, because of the perspiration. So many a times players use the powder to dry their hands. Early in the morning, 11 o'clock, not many people around here in the hall where it is played, but we'll see a crowd coming in the late afternoon. They would be keen on watching the finals. It's a working day, so can't expect people to leave alone their businesses, their jobs. They would like to watch the finals, the climax of the championships. Incidentally, in the institutional division, it is Petroleum Sports Promotion Board who have won both the titles in the men's as well as the women's section. In the men's section, they beat here. Sandeep couldn't play his shot in 10 seconds. He has to forfeit his turn, and now he is trying this cut with a rebound to displace the cluster. Zahir has a shot here. Oh no, he was trying one, but too much of power imparted. So PSPB, for PSPB, Mohammad Gufran beat Pankaj Pawar 10-25, 10-25, 7 of Jain Irrigation. K. Srinivas beat Yogesh Dhongde 17-18, 21-20, 25-14. And meanwhile, things not yet so clear on this board as Zahir goes for the rebound. What is he trying? Plays a dual shot, puts Sandeep in a spot of bother. The queen is close by, if I can really differentiate it between the whites, which have turned brown. Is that the queen that was pocketed? Very, very difficult. No, that wasn't the queen. Very difficult to differentiate. Very soon, if we are having these telecasts, the International Carom Federation will have to think of the color. No, it's very easy to differentiate from close quarters for the umpire, for the spectators who stand around, and for the players. Many of you will agree with what I am saying. Sandeep. The scoreboard hasn't been changed after the first set. Probably the umpire has forgotten. Still showing 25-4 at the end of the seventh board. There's Sandeep playing cat and mouse with Zaheer. Nobody keen on playing this pair. Pair means it is a little bit separated. When it is separated, it is a pair. Now he does it. What does Zaheer do? Play a wrong shot? Yes. Brings that white back. And it's called a cannon when the pieces are together and facing a pocket. And again Zaheer, defensive play, why not? Why allow your friend, of course they are friends. Now right now he is opponent, the initiative very early in the second set after having won the first. And now Sandeep manages to win and now the scoreboard will be rectified. In the women's semi-finals, Tuba Shelar, Sheher, from which state is she? She is from Chandigarh. She is leading against Rashmi Kumari, the first set. Rashmi Kumari is incidentally a world champion and won the International Carom Federation Cup. No, she was a runner-up. No, it was, I believe Ayesha was the runner-up and Apurva was the winner. Rashmi lost in the semis. And Apurva, the world and ICF champion, is leading against Neelam Godke of Jain Irrigation. Naga Jyoti, also of Petroleum Sports Promotion Board, she is leading against her own teammate Kajal Kumari by a set. And Khushbu Rani from Bihar, she is leading against local lady Ayesha Mohammed, formerly of Maharashtra and now representing Jain Irrigation. Ayesha is a former national champion, if I am not mistaken. She has a few international medals of the bronze variety. Zaheer not able to make headway. As I was telling you, the doubles in the institutional team championships was won by PSPB. And it was Ramesh Babu and Yogesh Pardesi, the former world champion, teaming together to beat Anil Munde and Rahim Khan 25-17-19-12. After some time, I'll update you on what happened in the women's inter-institutional championships, team championships. Nice alignment here, but then unproductive. Zaheer, too, for once, after breaking, hasn't made much headway. Probably this might clear the path for the queen. No. Sandeep, too, has a lot of work to do. He has to win two sets in a row, back to back. It's like being down two sets to love in tennis and then trying to win three sets. It's a difficult task. There he grabs the queen. For once he has played confidently. Is he going for the rebound? Yes. Because he had support over there of that white. Is he winning this board? Seems to be the way Zaheer is placed now. Sandeep will find it difficult. He has pocketed the queen. And I don't foresee Zaheer pulling up here. All five. Oh, can expect the unpredictable from him. Zaheer, where does Sandeep go? Goes to his right with a cut, a long cut. Doesn't matter, but now Zaheer, after pocketing one of the whites, does he displace the black? No, he is confident that he'll be able to pocket this. Sandeep must be praying, he let him miss this, and he misses. And Sandeep will be on the board with 7 points. So 7 love to Sandeep at the beginning of the second set. Good start after having lost 425 the first one. PSPB beat Jain Irrigation in the Women's Team Championships. It was 2-1. It was a close call with Kajal Kumari losing to Neelam Ghodke 13-25, 18-14 and 16-25. But Rashmi Kumari squared up the scores by beating Ayesha Saji 24-10, 24-9. And then Nagajyoti combined with Parimala Devi to beat Mitali Pimple and Farin 23-8. 25-11 to grab the title, to make it a grand double. PSPB with its, I would say, petroleum companies under its umbrella, encouraging a lot of players, giving them jobs, giving them good facilities. They're staying in a good hotel over here in Jalgaon. Big rooms, airy, air-conditioned, two carom boards placed over there, players practicing amongst themselves in their rooms, thinking carom all the time for 24 hours. So, good days for carom from the humble beginnings in which it started about 100 years ago in India. It's an indigenous sport, native to India. And about 55 years ago, the first time the Carom Federation was established, and the first ever champion was Suhas Kambli, somewhere in the late 50s or early 60s, I'm not so sure. He's still there around, guiding a few youngsters over here. He's there in Jalgaon, giving demonstrations. And he's a 5-time national champion, mind you, when championships were never held annually, sometimes after 4 years, after 5 years, after 6 years. So he ruled like a king for almost 20-25 years. And to maintain that form with primitive equipment and primitive facilities was indeed creditable. The queen is still there, if you can still identify the color. There is Sandeep now trying to play it. No, that is it the queen? I am still confused. It looks it's the queen. Now the press shot. Neatly played Sandeep. He is going to grab this one. Another 6 points. He is on a roll now. 13 in 2 boards. Suddenly he has struck a purple patch. That will worry Zaheer Pasha. But not much. After all, he is an accomplished player. He has faced so many situations earlier. Zaheer again rechecking the cluster. He has to be doubly sure, a little loose fitting and a loose arrangement means you may not have a good break. There the scissor grip. How many does he have? 4 and 4, 8. So just one. But he can play this shot, yes. He might get the striker back to break the cluster with the sharp cut. Nothing much achieved except the striker hitting 3-4 times on the frame. Zaheer has separated the queen, but then is going to play the one at the base, trying to slip it towards the right hand side. Sandeep now, having won the first two boards, 7 and 6 respectively, is on a roll. His confidence has been boosted a lot. He's no mean player. He's ranked 5 in India and Zaheer is 3. There is not much of a difference except on that particular day when you play each other. Disturbing the queen, and manages to pull it back in a favorable position. There, the black is there for the taking. Is he running away with this board? But a slight bother for him. Yes, he pulls that white one back so that he can have a better view of the pocket on his next turn. Zaheer will be able to pocket this one. If he does, I believe he'll take this board now. He'll just snatch it away, but then he'll have just four. Missing by a whisker, as they say. So the edge of the cliff. Sandeep is not going to let this go, not let go. Just one remaining. Let's see what happens. He is going to rue this. He had come back from the dead. Zaheer will just get one. Good to be on the board, even if it is one. And with the strike or the break going to Sandeep, he must be wondering, if I can get this one, I'll be closer to winning the second set. It's the fourth board now.
Big board, the second set. Sandeep Devi have 800 break. Score is 14 against 1.
Normally, the player who breaks, he has the privilege of sprinkling the powder, cleaning the board, as per the laws of the game. Sandeep has had a good break. See how he pushed that black away with a cushion shot. See, he has broken it at random, but doesn't matter. It has helped him a great deal. If he takes this one, he'll be able to negotiate the queen, which he will do readily now. Is he on the verge of a break to finish? Can happen if he takes the cover. There it is. Again, the slip between the cup and the lip. By a hair's breadth or a whisker's breadth, he has missed it. I wouldn't say missed it. A big board and you would have been winning the set. would have been closer to winning the set if not winning. He drops this one. Best thing to do. But now Sandeep will go for a rebound from a wider angle. Zaheer will clean up everything if he has the opportunity. If he can create an opportunity, there it was. Sandeep will go for a sharp cut. No, he's going for a rebound. Well done. If he can take this, then he can go for the queen and then can finish the board with 8 points. Again. I'm again confused. Is it the queen? I believe it is. Depends on what Zaheer is going to play next. The colors are tricky over here, difficult to identify. Even though the light is bright, the whites have become so brown. That isn't the queen. Forgive me. Let's find out who has covered it. And now Sandeep will get one at least if he has not pocketed the queen. There it is. Just about. So that was 1 point to Sandeep. So Zaheer had pocketed the queen. Four boards gone. 14-1 the score. One set lead for Zaheer Pasha of Reserve Bank of India. He is dueling it with Sandeep Dive of Air India. Zaheer to break, meaning he has the advantage. He has to somehow win this board. It's crucial for him to stay alive in the match. No doubt he's ahead, but again, why lose the second set when you have won the first quite comfortably? There is fumbling. His game has dropped a notch or two, certainly. That consistency isn't there to be seen. Oh, nicely done by Sandeep. But he hasn't benefited much, certainly. Random shot. Zaheer trying to come back into the match, or rather the second set. A little bit complicated, but these big players know how to solve complicated cases, complicated situations. Now he'll come with the rebound, yes. When in doubt, play defensively. So does Sandeep. For the first time, I'm seeing both players laboring to clear the board. He breaks the monotony, Sandeep. Play a press shot, no, badly timed and badly aimed. Nice one. Is he brushing this black? Yes. To separate the queen. Is to do something special. Is there a shot for the queen? No. How does he adjust this? Big player that he is, he will do it. Another shot in the center, and then he has just one thumb. What does he do? Does he play the thumb? No, he goes for this shot. Again, some fine adjustment is required. There it is. Can he get a cut or does he go for a rebound? I believe the rebound is there coming. Oh no. Ho. Can Sandeep finish it off again? He is capable. But is it possible? Sharp cut. And still has hope, because Zahir can't go for a rebound towards the left hand pocket, otherwise he'd have gone for a rebound. Best thing, I believe, he'll use his force to bulldoze his way. And Sandeep is better placed, certainly. There he is and should be moving ahead. Having not taken the queen, queen was taken by Zahir. So 115 the situation at the end of the... No, he has taken the queen, Sandeep, I'm sorry. Stand corrected, 18-1.
Seventh board on the second set. Sandeep
Dewey
of
Air India to break scoreage. So, next board again is crucial, or the one that is coming. Normally the fixed 6th and 7th boards are crucial. That depends on the situation though. Always good to break, you have the head start. And in many cases, these top players who accomplish break to finishes, they just race ahead. There wasn't space for that thing to wend its way. And Zahir has been struggling. First signs of struggle under pressure. Sandeep has 4 on the board and Zahir has all 9. Now he will reduce by playing with the left hand. See? Nothing much comes out of it. Not planned well. Because that's not your regular playing hand, and then you don't have control. The queen is there, yes. Takes it. The white there towards the left, sitting close to the pocket. Is he on the verge of winning the second set and returning the compliment? There it is, but unable to clear the block. This white, is it? No. No. Zahir will now make merry. The Maidan is clear for him. Maidan saaf hai. Only thing he has to be careful. Only thing he has to be careful. But that has simplified the situation for Sandeep. But if Zahir allows him, but it's a good miss, I would say. He will apply the double touch. No, now Zahir might slam it away. There he is finishing it. Remaining in the match at the end of the 6th board. To a level where it becomes more and more popular. Not that it is not popular. It is popular in towns, villages, cities, in offices, in malls, in corporations, corporate offices. It's played widely in India. I can still remember the institution for which I was working. Once upon a time, we used to have 8 carom boards in our recreation room. So you can imagine how widespread this game is. You can understand the base that it has. Both players must have refreshed, must have had a word with their seniors, their coaches, trying to find out what needs to be done, what they missed, and what they should not miss. So both the sets one-sided, Zahir Pasha winning the opener 25-4, Sandeep winning the second at 19-2. Zahir makes a good beginning. Will he get the striker back onto the cluster? How much power he'll impart? There it is. Has it helped him? He's wondering what needs to be done next. Is there a foul? Yeah. So he's been penalized. There must have been a touch somewhere, illegal touch of the striker, of the hand. Very difficult to say from here. So both the players agreed and the umpire decided. Of course, the decision is final. I heard Sandeep saying something to the umpire. I rather saw. The queen is out. Does Sandeep take it? No. Said, let's wait for some time. Now he's going for it. Since all 9 were on the board, if you haven't pocketed one of your carom men, you can't play the queen. That's for sure. You can't pocket it and cover it. You can play it, probably. So it hasn't been covered. So it comes back. It has to be closer to the center. As close to the center as possible. The center circle, I mean, which is red in color. Zahir trying a trick or two to separate the queen. He has to attack early. He doesn't want Sandeep to get a head start. There he's breaking it. Oh no, it was a little bit wild. He doesn't impart that much power. Sandeep again, a straight one. After having won the second set, that also at 2, his confidence should be sky high. This man from Air India should be flying sky high. Again a random shot. I mean, when in doubt, just hammer. Use the hammer. That jumped off the board. Anything that jumps off the board has to come in the center. And of course, if the queen is there, it is closer to the center. Nice one. Oh, that dual purpose. You have to succeed in such situations. You can't wait for the next turn because you know your opponent is as wily, as cunning as he can be. Here is an alignment. Oh no, he misses this one. Does that allow Sandeep to play the queen? I am interested about the queen. Why? Early in the match, if you can grab the queen and the 6 points, or rather the 3 points, can he? Yeah, he might. Yeah, he's trying to play this black, and that's a double duke. he'll be penalized to carom men now. One for the due and one. So if you pocket two and the striker follows, three come out on the board. It's always 1+1 for the due. Too much power. That led to that mishap. But now he can take the queen. He's paid a price for it. But has recovered. Grabbing one and the queen. Goes for the rebound. Neatly done. A press shot now. He succeeds. And now Zahir will punish him. Let's see. Again that miss, crucial miss. One miss and that is harming Zahir. It has harmed him in the second set. And now he's on the verge of losing the first board. So 4 points to Sandeep. Starts well. He isn't in the best of forms, Sandeep. But yet, he's doing well. Considering that after losing the first set at 4, came back, won the second at 19-2 in 7 boards. And now he's leading 4-0 in the third set. Three other quarterfinal matches going on simultaneously. Prashant More of RBI, the world champion, versus Zaid Ahmed of Air India. Nisar Ahmed from Maharashtra, from the neighboring district of Dhulia. The championships are being played in Jalgaon, playing Anil Munde of Jain Irrigation, an institute from Jalgaon. Irshad Ahmed from Vidarbha, the International Carom Federation Cup. Playing Abhijit Tripankar of Maharashtra. Abhijit too is a good player. So Air India having two men in the quarters, Maharashtra having two, Vidarbha, Jain Irrigation, RBI of course have two. So Jain Irrigation and Vidarbha having one each. They are the umpire, Ashish Bhakkar. Pointing to Sandeep that the cluster is not properly arranged, there is a gap. So he redoes it. Now you can see the difference between the queen and that white. You can hardly differentiate. You have to follow it all the time like a hound. Like the hound follows the quarry during a hunt. Too wild. Zahir. Again, glimpses of brilliance. The consistency is down. You have to complement brilliance with consistency. Otherwise, there is a danger of just drifting away from your goal, from your intended goal, rather, of winning. See, when he is pocketing, he is in a hurry, in a tearing hurry. And that's how he has missed this pair. He's trying the queen. Why not? There is a white here. Yes, lying. So he has the advantage now. If he can get this board, he will be in a very good position. Considering this is the third set. Go for a rebound, a defensive one. So that was a little half-hearted. There was a shot, according to him, but couldn't execute it. What does he do, Zahir? Yeah. he has to play this one, tries to maneuver it with a double touch. And Sandeep will disturb this, force Zahir to play this again. But Zahir can play the slip shot. No, this time it turns out to be a rebound. What is he trying? A rebound? Yes, neatly done. There was a gap and he spotted it. It was a good shot. I mean, shot of the day so far in this match. Did it confidently. Is he going for the glance rebound? Oh, sharp cut with a glance. Is there space for it? Oh, why does he play the black? Why didn't he play the rebound? That's the question I'm asking. But he has made that black move into such a position. There is no question now if we can grab this one. So 3-3, 6. And Dive has a 10-0 lead. Is there an upset coming our way? This is the question I am now asking at the end of the second set. Takes a bit of time for the umpire to, there he is now, stretching his left hand to update the board.
Third board of the setting set, Zahir Pasha of RBI.
Not very often the umpires face such situations of operating the board, because these facilities are available only in a select tournaments. So they just update the scorecard and then they tend to forget that they have to update the scoreboard. They will learn as they gradually keep on handling these gadgets frequently. It's a matter of, you know, habit. The habit has to be formed. And the habit is formed when you handle these gadgets on a day-to-day basis. Umpiring, of course, is a thankless job in all games. Nobody appreciates or likes an umpire, especially in games like cricket where you are given out, and the batsman never agrees that he's out. He'll keep on arguing. Anyway, that's of academic interest, as here Sandeep tries to consolidate his position. He is now pocketing accurately. It's a nice shot for a change. Those three are a little bit troublesome, but if he can pocket this again, the hammer shot. When in doubt, use the hammer and await the outcome. That seems to be the motto of all the players. But Zahir now is taking the queen. He has the board under control. Having broken, oh, 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 that just about drops in. He must have had his heart in his mouth. Oh, that dual purpose shot. Zahir might score now. Still a bit difficult for Sandeep. Is there a shot? There is. And this is the way players get out of difficult situations. So Zahir conceded the board. He knew he had lost it. Again, some problem with the board. I don't know what's happening. It's the third board. seems Sandeep has won. And there is change of sides now. Let's see how the umpire now rectifies the board. Let's see. He'll have to change the scoreboard. It is 15 love. So the changeover has facilitated us all. It has helped us to know the scores. What are they discussing? It's 13 love. So three were there. Zahir had taken the queen. The umpire has to be more attentive. He hasn't been so far as I see it. And Zahir, an elementary error. Not judging the line of the shot well. Sandeep, having broken this, will have to think a lot. There are a few there for the taking. But then the queen is there in a castle, surrounded by three blacks. How does he address that situation? Tries the rebound, but isn't successful. Two whites are free. Zahir has... And now... What I should say, landed in a ditch. His consistency has ditched him. Trying to play the queen, now a connection, if possible, no. Now he might play the connection with the queen. Or is he taking this black? This black first, okay? He will have to do something drastic. Again, the consistency is back. Does he go for the queen? There he does it. A little uncertainly, but he has the queen now. Now you should think of the board. There it is, that touch. And that carom man not hardly moving. Sandeep too finding it difficult. Fatigue also sets in. Focusing constantly on the board under bright lights. You tend to, you know, your eyes tend to get fatigued. Your vision tends to... Oh, nice shot here. Nice shot. He will get 2, so that would take him to 15. No, he plays spoil sport. Zahir pulls this back. Now he'll go for the rebound. No, he is following that black. Zahir can pocket this to me. No. Now a rebound should suit Sandeep. With the help of that black, no, not much power. Zahir might go for the sharp cut, which will push the white black. No, back. No, no, no. Can he pull it back with a rebound? The pair, it seems, I believe. No. Quite delicately balanced this board. Very important for Zahir to get his... He might get this one, I believe, if he strikes it right. Yes. So he's got 4 now, having pocketed the queen. So Sandeep Dive on white has yielded 4 points. again the scoreboard. The umpire is taking a lot of time to upgrade the board. Update the board rather.
Zahir Pasha Parker to break. Score is 4 against 13.
Zahir still in a spot of bother. And bother he will, because the difference is 9. One big board to Sandeep, and the door might be closed on Zahir. It can be the other way around also. One big board for Zahir, and the match would become intense. The fight will become intense, keen. Zahir has to win this one. Narrow miss. Both players are getting tensed up. Quite natural. There is no aim, proper aim in their shots. It's aimless play for some time. Finally, Sandeep breaks that monotony. Again, misjudging the pace. Zahir will pocket both. Yes. He's made way for the queen. He has to pocket the queen now. So that he remains in contention within striking distance of Sandeep, who is 9 points ahead. But this opens up the board now. I mean, you don't have to bother about the queen. When the queen is there on the board, it becomes a problem. Nice shot. This might to yield a result, yes. Only the one there towards the far frame. No. Even a player of his caliber misjudged the line of the shot. It happens. Mental fatigue. Visual fatigue. And early morning games are not good for a few players. They may not have slept the whole night thinking about their opponent, their own strategy. So sport is not a part-time job, it's a full-time profession, I would say, even if you don't earn much money. Here you have 3 lakhs in prize money. Quite good, considering that this was an humble sport once upon a time. 3 lakhs, of course, for the team championships, for the individual championships, for the veterans. But there is some money at least. And now you are looked after well. Now you are given good accommodation. You are given good food. So, nice one from Sandeep. How does he deal with the one that is sticking to the frame? Oh, that was quite innovative. Must have practiced this shot. Didn't come off in a pressure condition. And Zahir, he was now totally disappointed. So Sandeep inching his way further. at the end of the fifth set, again the umpire late in updating the scores. Should be 1 point to Sandeep, 14-4. It's becoming tense every passing board. This is going to be crucial. Whosoever wins big, possibly if Sandeep can win big, then he might run away with the match. He has the break. That's good. क्या हथौड़ा हमारा should be going for the queen. No, he isn't. He's going for the rebound over there. Too much power. You must calculate the amount of power that you have to apply. We'll have this shot adjusted, yes. Why is he not thinking of the queen? No, he's got this two in a rut. So there is a flash coming your way. Abhijit Tripankar of Maharashtra has beaten Irshad Ahmed, the recently crowned International Carom Federation Cup champion. A big, big blow. Big, big blow dealt by Abhijit Tripankar of Maharashtra. Abhijit has been in good form this season, and meanwhile Zahir Pasha grabs the queen. Neatly done. Is he going to punish Abhijit for that lapse while pocketing the queen? No, that was aimless. Now Sandeep has a chance. He can pocket this. There is a troublesome pair over there, white. Can he brush that black and play this white? Yes. And 5 points, if he grabs this, will make it 18. 18 it is to Sandeep Divay. He has suddenly found his touch, and Zahir probably wilting under that pressure, that onslaught by Sandeep. Sandeep having a sip of water, your throat becomes parched when in a tense situation, even though if you are leading. Zahir, can he turn the corner? Can he turn the tide? It's not going his way. The tide is against him. A sharp cut there. Zahir just nods his head in disappointment. And when things are going right for you, any shot, however you hit it, it becomes a good shot. Zahir for once have seen him a little bit nervous. His face isn't glowing as it was at the beginning of the match. This man from Malabar separated the queen. Has to take it. But where is the cover? Trying a sharp angle over here towards the lower pocket. Yeah. Good shot under pressure. Where does he play now? Which one? Can he connect something somewhere? Oh, that was a rebound taken at random. Meanwhile, Sandeep trying to So I have a few updates. Rashmi Kumari has won after trailing by a set against Tuba Sheher of Chandigarh. S. Apurva has already won against Neelam Godke. Naga Jyoti has won against Kajal Kumari, her own teammate. And Khushbu Rani of Bihar has won against Aisha Mohammed, which I told you earlier. And Abhijit, or rather, getting confused because Abhijit won there. Sandeep Dive and Abhijit are city mates. They are state mates, but playing for different teams here in the tournament. Abhijit playing for his state and Sandeep playing for his employer. So, still a ding-dong tussle, 19-4 to Sandeep Dive. The seventh board in progress. And this is crucial, absolutely crucial. What does Zaheer do now? He has to somehow deal with this. Can he? Oh no. Sandeep is going to grab this one. He misses. And Zaheer looking helpless now with that. And he pockets it against all odds. How much has that helped him? How much? Let's see the scores. So Zaheer has got 4, makes it 8-19 for him at the end of the 7th board. I'll shortly tell you the 2 results that I have got. I don't have the scores. But Prashant More and Nisar Ahmed have won their respective quarterfinals. Nisar Ahmed, after trailing, has beaten Anil Munde. And Prashant More has beaten Zaid Ahmed. So Nisar Ahmed, the surprise packet of the tournament, has won. And surprisingly, another Ahmed, Irshad Ahmed, who won the International Carom Federation Cup, beating the reigning world champion Prashant More, has lost, and he has lost to Abhijit Tripankar of Maharashtra. Of course, Vidarbha comes in Maharashtra geographically as a state, but then they play the nationals as 2 different entities. And then Zaheer Pasha conceding the match to Sandeep Dive.